This program comes to you compliments of Illinois International and Patricia's Bakery. Host makeup services provided by Beauty by Regine. Accessories for hosts provided by Afro Gypsy Nook.
Patricia's Bakery, located Government House Road, Scarborough, Tobago. Striving to be the best in the industry in which we operate. Ensuring good customer service through quality performance. Daily we offer fresh, affordable and tasty products. Catering and delivery services available. We're open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Contact us today at 365-0324 or 324-5606. Welcome to Heart of a Woman. I am Sean Devines Daniel, and today we are continuing. This is part two from our program where we talked about discovering intimacy in marriage. On set with me today is Miss Paletta Johnny. Hi, Paletta. Welcome again.
Thank you. Thank you.
And Nurse Guy, my dear sister in the Lord as well. You know, we were hoping that our gentleman from last week could have been here to join us, but sadly he's not here with us. So ladies, you know we are custom handling stuff, so we can handle this, right?
Yes,
we can handle this. So let's recap. Last week, Paletta, we spoke about we spoke about what is intimacy, you know, and that kind of thing. We spoke about intimacy, mm-hmm. the importance of communication.
Yes.
And even though we're going deeper into mm-hmm. this thing, it's still all about communication, right?
Of course,
we spoke about the physical communication that you should have. The physical aspect mm-hmm. of the relationship. Mm-hmm. We also spoke about, let me just look at my notes here. We also spoke about spiritual intimacy mm-hmm. as well. We spoke about physical intimacy, and we spoke about what was God's plan that. So we had a really good time, and we ended the program where we spoke about sexless marriages, mm-hmm. which, Nurse, I'm sure you know that even in your line of work, women would have shared situations like that mm-hmm. with you. And Paletta, you work with women all the time.
Yes.
And they would have shared that mm-hmm. with you. Even, strange enough, some men would confide in us. Men have confided in me mm-hmm. about that situation. It is a really big issue, especially in Christendom. Mm-hmm. And it is time to remove the mask. We're not covering up anymore, because there are people out there that need help.
Yes, they do.
You know,
yes.
We're not looking at ourselves as the great white hope or anything like that. But, you know, we do what we need to do for our sisters.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And by mm-hmm. extension, family life. Because family life is very important.
Yes,
agree,
it is.
Girls?
Yes, yes.
Right. So, picking up from where we left off last week, Paletta, mm-hmm. we spoke about sexless marriages. But, again, let's talk about what do you think, to you, what is sex?
To me, sex is what God created and intended for a man and a woman mm-hmm. to share. It speaks of coming together of two bodies, soul, mind, and spirit in that intimate moment. Mm-hmm. Right? It is a combination of what you would have done throughout the day, you know, moments leading up to it, where you just give yourself to that person without any inhibitions. You give yourself to that person, you know, because listen, I love you, and this is what God has designed for us to share as our way of showing our love to each other. That moment that you come together and it's like, oh God, I thank you because of this. Mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. And to me, that is what sex is. It's not something for children to be knocked about and share with people, but with this person that I desire to be with, I share this intimate room because I'm giving of myself. Unless you're a prostitute, but you can just share your innermost being with that person.
And of course, we are speaking about this in the context of marriage.
Of course, in the context of marriage.
Yeah.
That this is the person I'm sharing, I'm giving you of myself.
Mm-hmm.
You are entering in now. It's like intimacy is like into me, you will now see.
Mm-hmm.
You come there's no other. So that this is me now. You have unveiled.
Yes.
I'm naked and unashamed. There is no shame in this now. You're just giving yourself to that person. That is what sex is all about.
Yeah. Ms. Guy, what would you like to add to that? What is sex?
I agree with what she said, because mm-hmm. I mean, as she said, it's the whole thing about intimacy.
Yes.
Right? It's not just about the fact that, you know, it's just not just penetration, you know, of.
It's not just a penis
exactly
and a vagina.
It's
yes.
more than that.
It's more
you
than
know,
that.
It's, you're coming together, right? As she said, mind, soul, and body,
mm-hmm.
right? Where you know where you would have it entails foreplay, it entails kissing, hugging, you know. So it's not just about penetration,
mm-hmm.
right? All of the medical terms you will find where it would have a lot of hormones being, you know,
yes,
stimulated and all these different things.
Mm-hmm.
But I look at it way beyond that.
Of course,
you know,
yes,
it's
yeah.
more than just the hormones being released at this particular time, mm-hmm. you know, with the brain working with the different parts of your body and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
I look at it more than that. It's a holistic thing.
Yes.
You know, we come together.
That's it.
We sit, well, we lie down, whatever you want to do,
mm-hmm.
you know, and
mm-hmm.
you share that time with that person. So it's
yes.
more than just penetration.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with what she said.
And so, guys, what's the difference, you think, between sex and making love?
The difference with sex and making love. Sex, okay, is it part where you penetrate there's penetration.
Mm-hmm.
Love making or foreplay is when you spend time to caress and to know the person, spend time on their body, discovering the different areas that may cause arousal to the person,
mm-hmm.
right? That will cause you to be prepared for penetration, because some people, if you don't do that, some women suffer from dryness, and if penetration happens, sex becomes painful and hurtful to the
mm-hmm.
person, and it's not enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
So foreplay comes in, it's very important in leading up to the actual sexual act.
Right.
Is where you spend time, you know, you say, as a constant people, you say sweet nothings
yes.
to the person.
Mm-hmm.
So it's enjoy. So, so with that now, when there is penetration, I'm able to receive you.
Mm-hmm.
Better, and I'm able to enjoy the act now because my body is well prepared for it.
That's right. Yes.
So that's, to me, that is the difference of
between
of, yes,
that
sex. Yes,
and
definitely.
Right. So let's jump straight into now. We had the definition. We had your opinion on what it is. Let's talk about sexless marriages. People who don't have sex at all. They're married,
mm-hmm.
but they just don't have sex. You know, and I want to ask Nurse Guy,
mm-hmm.
let's clear it up with the medical stuff, that there may be people who are sick.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the illnesses that can cause a wife not wanting to or can't have sex with her husband?
Well, most of the time, right, you can have the physical aspect of it as
mm-hmm.
well as you can have the psychological aspect of it. Right? Physical means that the person is incapacitated in some way, right? Whether it be that they probably paralyzed, you know, something to that extent.
Mm-hmm.
And depending on the state of the paralysis, you find that they could still have that urge to have sex,
mm-hmm.
right? So you have the physical as well as you have the psychological aspect of it. And you find people who may not be in the, you know, right frame of mind, you know, that kind of bothers them, or it prevents them from having sex and enjoying it that the way that they should or they ought to, right? We have the basic stuff that women go through, the different developmental stage, like you have menopause and these
right.
different things
yes.
that may affect it. But I'm not going to say that it's going to prevent it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's going to prevent you from having sex, but you know, it may alter it, or you may find that it may what? Let me see, interfere with the way that you would respond,
the
or the, yeah, you know,
mm-hmm.
the way that you look at it, the way that you enjoy it, these different things. And you have different aspects where you have women who may or may not have been exposed to some type of rape or trauma, you know, some kind of abuse, you know, so these are the different things that could affect the way, you know, that somebody respects.
I've spoken to women and they would say, girl, after the three children, I get so fat. I ain't fine, not looking good. Me and what my husband to touch me, I ain't looking good. So do you think sometimes self-esteem as
it
well
does.
Could play a major role in not wanting to have sex because you of yourself don't feel that you're looking good?
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's the psychological aspect of it. Mm-hmm. Because I mean, if a woman is not comfortable in her body, right, there you will find that she's going to pull back. She's not going to be free. She's not going to be loose. You know, she wouldn't be comfortable to expose herself, right? So that in itself is part of the psychological aspect of it, right? You just had three children, you find that your tummy might be getting bigger, you find that your hips might be more expanded than before, you know, you have weight gain and stuff like that. So that is the psychological, that is one of the psychological aspect of it, where you find women, will they will pull themselves into a cocoon, you know, and especially if you're getting pressure from the other end, you know, the spouse, you find that they would not respond.
But, you know, I have a lot of male friends, and we will talk about stuff like this, and you know, they say, oh, we don't care if the wife put on a little pong, that is better for me to love. And that is what we don't understand, I think, as women, that it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. If you're becoming obese or it's going to make you sick or something, I get it. But to a man, he's not interested in that, you know.
Some of them,
right? But if your husband really loves you, and he knows that we are going to meet you, he was figure one. And as you get older, and even menopause too, this is not a menopause program, but you know, even with menopause, you put on weight. But I think it is important as women for us to really love ourselves, to embrace who we are. Yeah? So, Paletta, I know you're dying to talk about this, you know, not dying, but I know you're waiting there, but should a sexless marriage justify a man being unfaithful, a woman being unfaithful, you think?
It shouldn't, but in reality, it does affect marriages. Because there are times, okay, in case of illnesses, you would know, okay, the person has this ailment or that ailment. So, of course, with counseling from a doctor, you know, okay, this would affect your sexual desire. But if there is no justifiable reason, the person just turning their back or they choose to go and sleep in another room or whatever, with no expert, and you're asking them, well, what is happening? How, I mean, with normal human being, how long would somebody be able to take something like that? How long would somebody be able to tolerate something like that? So I mean, you don't want it to happen, but then there's always somebody out there who would always be there waiting in the wind to tell you, you're looking nice. And somehow there is I don't know what it is, but somehow men are just, good, that man ain't treating you right now, I gotta treat you right. You know, and they just wait until they tell you the right thing at the right time, and over time, you didn't set out for that, and over time it happened.
That's what I'm thinking, because you would talk to somebody who would have fallen into that kind of situation.
Yes.
But say, I didn't get involved in this relationship for sex. You know,
no
but
companionship.
Because I don't think that as women, even if you're in a sexless relationship, it is not so much the sex, you know. I think is the romance and the
intimacy.
And you will find somebody who will probably want to, not probably, who would give that to you.
Of course.
You know,
yes.
The attention. The attention, I think a lot of women get caught up for the attention.
Yes.
You know?
The compliments and so on, you know? The convenience, that person is always there for you. Where you may call your husband or whatever, and he can't pick you up, he's always busy, he's there, that person. I don't have any transport. Could you pick me up? They're there. I need to get something in the grocery. They're there. I need something to be done in the house. They're always there. So eventually, after a while, and then sometimes you go to the person, they're seeking advice.
Which is wrong, eh?
It's wrong.
Yeah.
It's wrong.
Yeah,
for,
but something, because of the fact that you may want to know, okay, how does a man think? How if somebody's not doing that, why would he not be doing this? And you're seeking knowledge.
Yes, yeah. I mean, natural instinct.
Natural instinct to get to understand right. how does a man think.
Yeah. Yeah. So guys, I see we're not warming up, we're not getting to the juice of the thing. We have to take a short break and we'll be right back. Patricia's Bakery, located Government House Road, Scarborough, Tobago. Striving to be the best in the industry in which we operate. Ensuring good customer service through quality performance. Daily we offer fresh, affordable and tasty products. Catering and delivery services available. We're open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Contact us today at 365-0324 or 324-5606. Welcome back to Heart of the Woman. And on set is my dear friend Paletta and my dear friend Kelly.
Yes.
And we, you know, we're talking about how, you know, what we were talking about, infidelity.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're in a sexless marriage, is it justified? Mm-hmm. Should you do it? You know. So Paletta, you were in the midst of something and you were so fired up about it, you know. If you could remember.
Right, I was saying that sometimes you go to another man seeking advice.
And a woman too, because we don't want to see one side.
Yeah. Well, well, yes, you go to someone of the opposite sex because it could happen either way.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted to know, well, why is this? Why would someone, nothing is wrong in your mind with you, you have no hiccups or hang-ups about what happens in the bedroom, why would this person not be having sex? So you go to say, well, okay, as from a man's perspective, from a woman's perspective, what happens? And so you start developing a relationship with this person because you're seeking advice as to how, and the person may be telling you, okay, girl or sir, try not try this or that.
Mm-hmm.
But then in your mind now, you start building this attraction, you start building this connection with the person, and before long, you start comparing.
Mm-hmm.
The comparison starts.
Exactly.
Why can't my spouse be like this,
like this
person?
Yeah.
This person is so understanding and so, and eventually, a relationship develops and it becomes sexual after a while.
Yes.
You don't
set,
as I said, you don't set out for that, but in reality, that is what happens. So that's why I want to tell men and women who are looking at this program, do not take your relationship for granted. Do not take your mate for granted. I don't care if they have wings of an angel. God created sex for married people, and you need to give the, what is rightly to your spouse, what they deserve.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says in Corinthians, if you have to abstain from sex, then you do it because of fasting.
Exactly.
And as soon as you are finished, you go back to your mate, lest the enemy steps in.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times we allow the enemy to come into our marriage because we take persons for granted. And I mean, it's something that needs to be addressed
address.
In marriages.
Yes.
It needs to stop.
Yes.
It is not correct. It is not right that you are withholding yourself from your husband or wife. If you have a problem, deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about it. Seek counseling if you have to. Pray about it, but do not leave your marital bed unattended.
Yes.
It isn't right.
I really think that a lot of, and not that I'm bashing my sisters, but a lot of women, especially believers, we have Christian husbands, and we think, well, they're saved.
Mm-hmm.
So then we're looking at no man, no woman.
Mm-hmm.
They're saved, they love God, so they wouldn't stray. And that's a foolish thing, eh? That's a foolish sense of comfort or whatever that you have.
Mm-hmm.
The point is that they are men. They have eyes and they have feelings and they have needs and they have desires.
And
so
the natural instinct is to observe what is going on around
exactly.
you.
Of course,
exactly.
Of course,
so just as some of the women may not go into a relationship for sex, for comfort,
the same thing applies to a man. Yes.
You know, so we need to be mindful of that, sisters. So let's talk about the role passion plays in a marriage. I know as women, we are so passionate. And I hear a lot of women saying, My husband here romantic, now he just boring.
Mm-hmm.
Passion. What do you think about passion, Kelly? What is passion to you? Because I think it's different for different people.
Yes.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. What I think, when I mean, passion to me is that desire. You know, the feeling that comes, you know, just...
Is it in a look? Is it when your husband look at you from a distance? It stirs something up.
It could be anything.
Yeah.
Right? Passion is that urge for me. Yes, that kind of sense of, you know, I want to and I must. And, you know, the thing that stimulates the whole excitement in it.
Yeah.
You know? So that's how I see passion.
Yeah.
Right? And passion must be a part of your marriage.
Yes.
It must be a part of your sex life.
Mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
In order for it to work.
And with passion, you're not even going to the sex yet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that has to be something that you cultivate in the marriage.
Yes, exactly.
That
yes.
you and hers, he could be across the room and you could look at him and he could look at you and he could say, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, mm-hmm. You know, that kind of thing.
Yes,
you know, it all comes, I think, too, with connection and mm-hmm. that intimacy we've been talking about. When people hear you talk about intimacy, they only think about sex.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not talking about that. We're talking about that connection.
That's right. That's right. That's
you know,
right. That's
that
right.
connection. Mm-hmm. And people need to start to talk about how they feel. You're my husband. You're my wife. I feel this way. I like it this way. Mm-hmm. I don't like to be touched here. Those things that I think, especially in the kingdom,
yes.
we are supposed to be happy and enjoying.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. Yes.
And I think that of we course. Are suffering because we don't talk about these things. Yeah. So, can a couple be happy without sex in their marriage? Be not so, no trauma. Because
mm-hmm.
we talk about that.
Mm-hmm.
If you had trauma and you're not able,
mm-hmm.
but everything is good. Man healthy, woman healthy.
I would say they could.
They could?
It depends on the couple. Of course, they could.
Really?
Of course, they could.
I would love
Let's
to
look at it from this perspective.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You and your husband, right? I don't know what agreement you remember you said. Sex.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Sex is, we look at sex and from the perspective of penetration and these different things.
Mm-hmm.
But if me and my husband, we could foreplay, right? We could reach the point where we could have heightened senses and heighten the arousal and we could reach a point where we could satisfy each other, we could have an orgasm. Why do we need sex? Think about it. So it could work for a couple.
Well, I'm very quiet.
It depends, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because the same thing you could get with penetration, you could probably get it with foreplay,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's look at it from that perspective.
Mm. I never looked at it like that, you know. But I'm all out there, so I never looked at it from that.
Yeah.
But what's
it
what? Yeah,
on the couple,
it depends
so
on the couple.
You have to know what will work for you.
Yes,
as you
yes.
say, if there's no form of trauma, whatever, I don't think
mm-hmm.
that there should be, you know, the abstinence of sex.
Right.
Right. But the couple supposed to know what is best for them.
For them.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yes.
Which will be more effective.
Yes.
Right.
Right?
Yes.
And you agree?
I agree because it depends on what the season or the time of your life
mm-hmm.
you may be going through. It may require, okay, because of this season, your menopause or your midlife crisis or whatever, I'm not feeling that way, but okay, we can do this to satisfy us. As I said, marriage is honorable, your bed is undefined. Whatever you choose to do
mm-hmm.
to get your satisfaction,
exactly.
but it should be an agreement.
Between the both parties.
Both parties
one
must agree
satisfying.
That
mm-hmm.
this is what is going to happen now because of this is of what is happening in our lives. It could be that, okay, we're in a situation where we all in one room.
Exactly.
You and the children in one room, so therefore.
Right.
Yeah.
It's not feasible
mm-hmm.
for us to be doing this and you have three, four children inside of the room. So, you know, in a case like that, okay, we could do as much and no more.
Right.
So I think it all depends on the situation that you're dealing with.
Mm-hmm.
But as I said again, it should not be a case of not doing it because you
don't want to
do it or try to be to victimize the other person.
That's
right.
Right. That's right.
I want to jump back a little bit to infidelity
mm-hmm.
and how you guys think infidelity can affect a marriage, and even the sexual part of it? How could a spouse be not faithful? What role would that play in a woman saying, "Is it me?" Shop close up.
Well, it would affect you. Trust.
Mm-hmm.
Can I trust this person? Yes. Then you have your health issues.
Yes.
How many person would he have slept with?
Exactly. That might only be one, you know about.
Exactly. You know, so therefore you have to think about your own health.
Mm-hmm.
And then too, as a woman, it causes you to wonder, why would he do that? It hurts your self-esteem.
Mm-hmm.
As a woman, your confidence is like, I gave him my best. I did my best. What was the reason for him going out there to be fulfilled?
Right.
So it erodes that confidence and yourself, because mm-hmm. you're wondering, mm-hmm. what was wrong with me?
What did I do?
Where did I go wrong?
What am I not doing?
Mm-hmm. So therefore, it really affects you. And then for you to go back there is trust. I mean, you don't know what he's bringing back into the marriage.
Yeah, what he's bringing to the bed, right?
Exactly. You don't know. So because you go and get tested and so on, and then of course it is a process. You don't, even though you come and you say, "I'm sorry, it was whatever reason." Don't expect automatically.
Is it sorry that I got caught?
So it's not that you could come back one time. It'll take a while. That trust has to be regained. It has to be regained.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
I have
mm-hmm.
to forgive you and be able to forget it.
Yeah.
Because I can forgive you and not forget it.
Right.
But exactly. I have to forgive
you. But you'll be challenging to forget it.
Yes. And be able to, okay, to accept you as, okay, let's start a clean slate.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the past. I'm mm-hmm. starting on a clean slate now. And mm-hmm. let's deal with from day now until mm-hmm. whenever.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. So it takes time.
Kelly, this might seem like a weird question, mm-hmm. but are there any benefits, health-wise, you know, healthy benefits to having good sex, healthy, and any benefits, health-wise?
Of course, mm-hmm. it does, right? Because, I mean...
And Paletta just smiled. Yeah.
All right. Look at it from a psychological aspect, right? You are having sex, right? You're comfortable with your partner, right? You do it whichever way that is pleasing to you, you know, you have that itself, it encourages the self-esteem of the two individuals, you know, to grow. You know, it also develops a sense of trust, mm-hmm. right? And in all of that, that connects with the holistic part of you, eh? Because mm-hmm. remember, we are not just the physical man,
yes.
right? We have the spiritual aspect, we have the intellectual, you know, mm-hmm. we have the emotional, mm-hmm. you know, so sex is also that forms part of the holistic man,
mm-hmm.
you know, where, you know, you feel comfortable, you know, you feel yeah. good, you know, you feel you have somebody to love you, somebody that, you know, you could turn to and say, "Honey, you know, I think we need to have this," you know, yeah. that kind of feeling, yes. right? You have somebody there that you could turn to. It's a wonderful feeling.
It does. Oh, it is a wonderful feeling.
It yeah. does. It has a lot of health benefits, eh? Because, and I'm thinking that some women, I don't know, you will see that, you know, they're having sex more. You find that they may have a little glow
mm-hmm.
in their yes. face. They sit in the skin. They look more relaxed. They're not as tense as before. You know, some people look at it as a form of exercise.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, they... Whatever, if it's a 15 minutes,
I do think you burn some calories.
It's up to you, yeah, you burn some calories, right? So it does have health benefits.
I just wish that, you know, in that instant we will lose like 10 pounds.
Amen.
That'd be so great.
Exactly true.
Then we'll have more. If we lose it more. Right? Yeah, and maybe even what about high blood pressure and stuff like that? You know, do you think it could help?
Well, I would say from a medical perspective. I don't know if there's any study
mm-hmm.
where you can relate not having sex with the management of blood pressure.
Okay.
Right? I've never heard about it. I don't know if there's any. I've never really done any research concerning it. Mm-hmm. But it's possible. Mm-hmm. Right? Because, I mean,
it's a stress reliever.
For me, when I look at it, it's a stress reliever.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is. And if it is that it helps to relieve your stress, when you stress free, you find that your blood pressure may decrease.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It may decrease.
And so, we want to make it abundantly clear that we're talking right now about sex in the context of marriage, eh?
Yes,
mm-hmm.
yes.
That's
so
right.
We
yes,
make
that's
sure
right.
we
that's
we
right.
letting people yes. know that. Paletta, we just touched a little bit on foreplay,
mm-hmm.
and that is a big issue, because yes. even last week you spoke about you said it so. You're very poetic about it, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but Paletta, hold on. So we're talking about foreplay. We're taking a quick break and we're coming right back to foreplay. Patricia's Bakery, located Government House Road, Scarborough, Tobago. Striving to be the best in the industry in which we operate. Ensuring good customer service through quality performance. Daily we offer fresh, affordable and tasty products. Catering and delivery services available. We're open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Contact us today at 365-0324 or 324-5606. Okay, guys, welcome back to Heart of a Woman, and we're jumping straight into it. Foreplay. Let's talk about foreplay. How important is this in marriage?
It is extremely important in marriage.
Mm-hmm.
This is what is necessary in getting both persons ready for the sexual act. Without it, it's like eating crickets without water.
Okay.
Put it that way.
Mm-hmm.
You
dry
need,
throat.
You're struggling, my sister. You're choking there. Bless God. So
yeah.
I'm saying to us, it is something that is important, and it is something that has to be developed between the two persons.
Mm-hmm.
As I said last week, what will work for Jean may not work
for
Jane,
June,
may
right.
not work for Janet.
Mm-hmm.
And the same thing with Tim, Tom, and Tommy,
mm-hmm.
right? You have to know the person that you are with, the individual that you are with. What pleases the person?
Mm-hmm.
My body is yours, as in Solomon.
Yes.
And so therefore, you can discover what pleases me. So it's not just, I kiss you two rub and two kiss and I'm ready. It doesn't work that way.
Mm-hmm.
We need to understand that foreplay takes time. So if you're in a rush, forget it. I mean, of course, don't get me wrong. There are times we all do our little quickies.
Mm-hmm.
Can I say that on television?
Yes, you can
right.
say quickies.
So there are times we all do that. The little midday rendezvous and so on. But once you want to please your wife, you have to take time off to romance her, to get
mm-hmm.
her ready in that mood, so that when the time of penetration comes, she's able to enjoy it. And you are both able to enjoy your sexual encounters.
Mm-hmm. And I do believe, I don't care if you would agree with me, foreplay for me is not just a touch on the whatever and the whatever. As you say, what works for Janet might not work for
yes.
Jane. I believe a nice little phone call throughout the day, a little compliment
yes.
about
of
what
course.
You're
yes.
wearing, you know, even talking about the little tryst we had last night, that kind of thing, you know, to, you know. So Kelly, imagine, I sat in the play for you.
Mm-hmm.
You're at work and you wear white, right?
Mm-hmm.
White, and you have all your people around, and you get this phone call. And all of a sudden, Kelly, this smile on your face. Best mood ever. That's from the hussy, eh?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Well, as I said, you wouldn't be able to function for the rest of the day.
Okay.
I mean, because, I mean, it stimulates that
yes.
sense of
yes.
worth, you know, as a woman. It stimulates that sense of worth, you know. So I went through the day and I excited to go home.
And then looking at the clock.
Exactly.
Saying, but it's still nice.
Time.
You're even nicer to patients now.
It puts you in a good mood.
Yes.
It puts you in a good
mood. Still go, she's a nice nurse, yeah?
Yes.
Yes. They don't know what's going on in their head.
This part of the thing too.
Yeah. Yes.
They're getting the side effects of it.
Exactly. Exactly. So, you know, they're good to go.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Your husband is a pastor.
Yes, he is.
Let's touch that.
Mm-hmm.
We feel that a lot of your pastors are not men.
Really?
Yes, that they don't have desires, that they don't have feelings, you know, that they don't need what other men need. And I do believe this man has to shepherd
so much
people. Yes, he has so many things. Imagine the wife at home saying, honey, you see me? No sex. And nothing. And he himself too, well, okay, if I get it, I get it. So no foreplay. He needs that as well, agree?
Of course. I mean, it is madness to think that because he's a man of God, a man of the cloth, a prince of power, whatever you choose to call him, that he does not need it. At the end of the day, the fact is, he is still a man.
Yes.
Right? And we need to understand that he still has his desires, his needs need to be met just as anyone else. And even more so because he put it on plenty, so you need to put back into him, you need to inject that time back into him to minister to his needs also. So it is important, and pastors, wives, I'm speaking to you too, take time off your husband. Let the congregation know that there are times that they can call and times that they can't call.
Yes.
I had established a fact that on Saturday morning, don't call my house before 9 o'clock because I'm working whole week. We are out all week, so on Friday night is our time. So we go out on a Friday, we come back whenever, and we sleep late on a Saturday morning, so do not call my house before 9 o'clock. Because that is our time. We get up, we take breakfast late. We, you know, so it is important that you establish, that even in ministry, that you have your time for your family and for your wife. It is important.
It is very important.
The needs, needs to be met.
Yeah, and touching on that as well, and we kind of go into a spiritual aspect, when a pastor or a minister or anybody, you know, you've ministered and you finish ministering, these men are vulnerable, eh?
They are.
They are vulnerable, and it's the responsibility of wives to handle that.
Definitely.
To handle that. Agree?
Definitely so.
So you need to take care of that.
Of course, you need to be there for your husband. And in opposite to, because there are wives who are in ministry.
Wives,
and their husbands
exactly.
who have to support.
Right. Yes.
So therefore, you need to be there. The foot rubs, the hot tea, the massages. You need to be there to minister to their need also.
Exactly, because they just poured out.
They just poured out.
Yeah.
And so people need to respect that. Okay, on a Sunday afternoon, allow the pastor to spend time with his family. You know, some people call 12, 1 o'clock in the morning, pastor cast up some demon.
Hello?
In the name
your
of Jesus.
Stories in the name of Jesus. I'm saying this straight up.
Yes, I mean, we need to respect that he is a man, he has his responsibility, just as any other man does.
Yes.
So therefore, we need to, let's work the program. He has his office hours, it has... You know, and it speaks to spiritual growth to us as membership.
As membership, yes.
What
I do agree.
We need to, we taught the word, and when things happen, we have power to the Bible. Inside, only the pastor have power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We also have power in the name of Jesus to cast out demons. Somebody is sick, my child has fever, to call the pastor to pray for the child. You are there, get oil, and you pray for the child has fever. So therefore, it speaks to maturity as congregants also, that we respect the role of the pastor.
Yes.
And that he has a family, and he has a wife that has needs, people. Amen, bless the Lord, thank you, Jesus.
So,
I'm just saying, thank you, Jesus.
I can't catch myself.
This is so beautiful.
So, yes, Paletta.
Yes,
so, we're talking about foreplay.
Yes.
After that foreplay, we want to have sex. Right? Now, I've heard sisters say to me, where is this thing that all ladies talk about? Orgasms? Orgasm, they don't know the word. I'm serious. I never had that. They never had an orgasm. Nurse Kelly, what is an orgasm?
I'll give you my definition first.
Please do.
I see orgasm as the heightening of your senses, right? From arousal, right? You have stimulation, right? Where you have the muscles in your body acting with your brain, releasing these different hormones, right? And that is some stimulation, right? And you find it's more like it's a phase, right? So you have that where it releases the hormones and stuff like that, you reach the point where you heighten, arousal, everything is there, and these hormones are released, and then you get back into a phase where you go back into relaxation of the muscles and these different things.
Mm-hmm.
That is just my definition of what an orgasm is.
Can I tell you my definition?
Sure.
So I love ice cream, right? Okay, well, everybody know I'm weird. So I love ice cream and I love wafer cones. And I don't like one scoop of ice cream when I'm having a cone. I want a big cone. I don't like small cones, right? I want a big cone. And so I'm having my ice cream. That's the foreplay. And actually, foreplay to me is when the lady taking out the scoop of ice cream and I'm thinking about how I'm going to devour that ice cream,
bless
right?
God.
So I have my ice cream and I'm having my ice cream. Orgasm for me is my wafer cone. Boom.
Boom.
Yes. You understand? That is just me. That's a TV way of me talking about that. So that is how I would put that, you know? Right, Pauletta?
Yes. Well, okay, I did some research. So this is from WebMD, so...
A medical... Yeah.
Orgasm comes from the Greek word orgasmo, which means swelling or excitement. It is a sexual climax or high point. It happens and it has you have a sudden discharge of accumulated sexual tension. That is the definition on WebMD for what happens in orgasm.
Yes.
To me, it's like the icing on a cake.
Right.
It's like the...
Because you love cake.
It's the icing on the cake that tops it off. It's a dessert to an 8-course meal. We're talking 3-course cake. We're talking about fine dining.
Yes.
Fine dining is 8 courses. So it is the dessert to an 8-course meal. That is what orgasm is. It's a pivotal point in your body where your body you shudder, you shake, you tremble, because there's nowhere else to go. This is it. You have hit cloud 9 and going on cloud 9.5.
Yes.
This is what orgasm is. If you have never had that, then you have not had an orgasm.
Mm-hmm.
It is something that you know your body convulges. You have the curling. Some people cry. Some people scream. Some people.
And it is okay.
It is okay
at that point to say, thank you, Jesus.
If you can be that
hallelujah.
Holy.
If you can be holy, because we're keeping it real.
If you can be that holy.
Yes.
I mean, some people say other words.
Yes.
Let's go.
Right. And if that works in your marriage, it's fine.
Fine.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes you burst out in tongues because, I mean, you don't have anything to say. You burst out in tongues, shakara bro seke da, because of what is happening to you at
yes.
that moment.
Yes.
Because, I mean, it sex is worship.
Mm-hmm.
When God designs it, he designed it as worship. So, therefore, this is heightened worship you
yes.
are dealing with between a man and his wife.
Yes,
so,
I
therefore,
agree.
When two persons, I mean, you love each other, you are sharing. It's not that I'm having sex and I'm thinking about somebody down the road or I'm thinking about what am I cooking tomorrow. You at that point, I'm focusing on that person.
And that is something that we were talking about last week about. Sex is good because it is from God.
Yes, it is.
But
yes.
What has
yes,
happened? The
yes.
devil has perverted it.
Of course.
And I think that is why people have such a taboo and such a hush. And there are women, Kelly,
yes.
that have no idea. They've never experienced
exactly.
an orgasm.
So these are different cultural practices. You know, you come from different backgrounds, different religion, and they just have different taboos about what sex is. What you shouldn't and what you shouldn't do, what you should be exposed to, what you should not be exposed to. So, and I thank God for being who I am and for being where I am, that I can share the experience. But, you know, I mean, hard, I'm feeling sorry for some of my sisters and around the world who hasn't had the experience too. But what can we do? We pray for them, right? But sex on the whole, orgasm, is a natural thing that comes when you have that connection with that person, you know, that connection where you reach, as she said before, the heightened point, you know, where there's nothing else to do, right?
Yeah.
So then you have all these.
But what do you think are some of the problems, guys, that say for physical issues or even traumas we spoke about before? Because I know a gentleman told me that because his wife was raped, she doesn't want to be penetrated.
Mm-hmm. You will get that.
However, she would have a climax. Mm-hmm. My oral sex. Mm-hmm. And I've heard, you know, people saying,
yes,
that's a no-no. So let's take a quick break and we'll come right back to what we're talking about. Patricia's Bakery, located Government House Road, Scarborough, Tobago, striving to be the best in the industry in which we operate, ensuring good customer service through quality performance. Daily we offer fresh, affordable and tasty products. Catering and delivery services available. We open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Contact us today at 365-0324 or 324-5606. Okay, guys, we're back and we're talking about orgasms. Mm-hmm. Yes? And I was just sharing with you guys that there's some women that can't have an orgasm through penetration. My name is Kelly.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That's true.
And a lot of them will have an orgasm through oral sex.
That's right.
My question is this, as believers, and this is your opinion, this is not the opinion of TIN, we're talking. Do you think that as a married couple, you should not have oral sex?
I wouldn't say you shouldn't. I think that what happens in the bedroom between a man and his wife, exactly, is between the man and his wife.
Right.
What works for you may not work for me. Mm-hmm. Right. And I have not seen anything in the Bible, and I can be corrected.
Right.
Where it said you cannot have it. I know that what happens in the bed, because there are medical reasons, mm-hmm, why some people cannot have. There are men who have diabetes and they can't have an erection. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm, therefore, what are you going to do? So you fulfill your wife, because you need to talk about. Yeah, then you have sex toys. What is the take on sex toys? So you and your partner decide, your spouse decide, what will work for you, what arouses you. Some people like to dress up. Mm-hmm. Some people, they put on different costumes. I mean, there's something naughty school girl. That is what works for them. Mm-hmm. And so
maybe like even Kelly's skirt will get a little short.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. So you know you have the different role playing. That is what works for you. Some mm-hmm people like taking chances. That is what arouses them. Okay, people can't pack up anymore and do a quick thing anymore. So sometimes being risky is what arouses them, some taking people a chance. That's on the beach, up the fort. You know, so those are the things that arouses some people. So it all depends on the person. They have mm-hmm to make that decision of what works for them. I have my personal view, but it is up to the person to decide what works for them.
And that was the question the person asked me. Is oral sex a perversion? Is there anything in the Bible that says we should not have oral sex? You know, so I think all the taboos mm-hmm about sex are some of the reasons why, especially as believers, we can't enjoy God's gift to us, yes, which is sex. Mm-hmm. And I think as believers, as born-again believers, we are the ones that should be enjoying this part of our marriage. Right. You know, it's so very important mm-hmm that we enjoy that, right? Should a wife fake an orgasm, guys?
No, she shouldn't.
Why? Kelly?
Think about it.
Hold on. Before you give me the answer, you know, I like to set the stage. Mm-hmm. Hussy feel he all that. Mm-hmm. He know what to do. And for years, she's been letting him feel he know what to do. But you're working in an office with people like Miss Paletta here.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You understand? And this woman hearing about this thing, and she want to know what it is. But Hussy not doing the right stuff. Mm-hmm. But she don't want to hurt him. Mm-hmm. What should she do?
Kelly, why would you fake an orgasm, right? Because as she was saying before, right? You have to know what is going to work for you, mm-hmm. right? This is why we have the big C in marriage, which all leads to communication, mm-hmm. right? So if there's no level of communication within that marriage and say, well, all right, this trust, we could say, all right, we could trash out our sexual issues, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Honey, you know, I find it didn't come up, let's talk about it. We could do it this way, we could try this way, this is not the way how I like it, this is how I like it. You need to communicate with your spouse as to what is going to work for you. Now, mind me, as Paletta was saying, there's only 25% of women that actually get an orgasm through mm-hmm. penetration. Mm-hmm. Right? So it tells you that what's wrong with the next 75? There's nothing wrong, but what you need to do is that you need to know what is going to work for you mm-hmm. as a couple, mm-hmm. right? Different reasons. We all structure different. We have different issues in our life. We have our spouse are different in many ways. So you need to sit down with your spouse and say, okay, honey, I think we need to try this. Mm-hmm. This didn't work. I didn't feel comfortable. This was painful. Let's try it this way. Yes. All right, and there's nothing wrong in experimenting mm-hmm. because you have to experiment until you have it right. Right?
Right. So even my daughter challenged me with that ability when we were talking. Yes. She's saying, Mommy, yes, we're saying experiment. But then when you have books and movies like 50 Shades of Grey, mm-hmm. as believers, how far do we go? You understand? My thing for this is, if you are a believer, and Holy Ghost lives in you. Mm-hmm. Sex is good.
Yes.
Sex is very good.
Very good.
And sex is not a perversion. Mm-hmm. Let's put that out there. So you would not pervert your sex life. That is just how I see it. Because mm-hmm. I think we could enjoy sex without anybody tying you. Because nobody can tie me up. I come out of bondage, I mean going back.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
You understand? Mm-hmm. Tying me up is physical bondage. Mm-hmm. That ain't working for me. Mm-hmm. You understand? And nobody ain't putting nothing in my mouth and holding my neck down. Hello, please. You understand? That is bondage in itself. Mm-hmm. If you want me to beat you, I will beat you because you deserve licks. But that is not a turn on. You understand? Beat me, I will beat you. And after the licks, that is it.
Well, then all of a sudden, all this stuff together.
Exactly. So don't come foolish and tell me foolishness about that turns me what I need. Yeah. I will beat you and then I will take it to the pastor, pull it, I will call you, not Saturday morning, no. So I think Holy Spirit lives in you. Mm-hmm. You must know boundaries. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing with alcohol. Why wouldn't go down by the bar and drink a rum and a beer or whatever? You have boundaries and that's not who you are. So I don't think that should even be a conversation, really. And if that is, then you definitely that you need some help. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing with so we say we need help. So yes. Some people say, well, pornography works for me. No, it does not. Mm-hmm. Then you're having some issues here that you need to deal with, you know, because sex is not a perverted thing.
It isn't.
Yeah, I agree. What's your take on that?
It isn't. And there are books written by Christians mm-hmm. that can help us.
Yes.
Because my husband and I do counseling mm-hmm. and before the couple get married, a couple of days before they get married, we have books that we would give to them to mm-hmm. let them understand their bodies and sexual function and role playing and so on, so you understand what you are getting into.
Yes.
Right? So there are things that are there to help you. And no one person knows it all.
Exactly.
As I said, some people take it for granted. There's just this young boy who was saying, but I really gave it to she last night. But the boy is 16 years old and bragging, in a public place that I really rough sex doesn't mean that it's good sex.
Exactly.
So some of the things that we think that, we are good and I'm going to pat my back because I really. No. Mm-hmm. You need to understand your woman, her body, how it works, how it functions, what turns her on, what arouses her. And the thing with it is sex is not selfish. We need to mm-hmm. say that.
Yes.
It's not a selfish thing. Okay, as a man, I have an erection and I climax and that's it.
And I think if a husband is selfish, it is a sin. I mean, that's a sinful thing. Mm-hmm. If you know, having sex with your wife, and I don't care how she feels.
Yeah,
you
and
know, but you're selfish.
Yes, and yeah. You are left as a woman. You left
unsatisfied.
Unsatisfied because yeah. I mean, mm-hmm. you are there, and before you could start, it finished. Mm-hmm. So you want to know what just happened?
I might as well just have boiled an egg or something.
Yeah. Know? So I'm just saying we need to understand that. If you are going to please your wife, and that is what you should do, mm-hmm. because if you love your body as Christ loved the church, yes. Christ didn't die half the way or go half the mm-hmm. way to the cross. Mm-hmm. He went all the way. So therefore, if I love my wife, it is my desire to please her, to make her happy. Mm-hmm. In every way, I provide housing, I provide shelter, mm-hmm. I provide food, I provide transport, I provide protection. Therefore, this is our time as adults. So therefore, I need to be able to satisfy my wife. And yes. if therefore, rubbing her toe is what satisfies her, I'm going to rub her toe until she's satisfied. Mm-hmm. And so mm-hmm. we need to come to that place of putting the importance on the two persons. As wives also, we need to know that my husband loves this. And therefore, this is what he's going to get. Because it goes both ways. It goes yeah. both ways. Mm-hmm. So the times when in our grandmother's and great-grandmother's time, where it used to be a chook, you'll get up and want something and dies it. Mm-hmm. And she don't know what happened. And for many people, sex is about having children.
Yes.
So after she gets pregnant, you don't touch her for the next 9 months.
9 months.
And mm-hmm. after 3 months after that, she gets pregnant again. So that is what sex is. Just to be able to have children for procreation. I mean,
Let me answer that. As you know, in addition to that, I think we too advance in technology and information. That, you know, people not, we need to make time to read, yes. edify Educate ourselves, yourself. You know, and mm-hmm. we need to spend mm-hmm. time and exploring each other.
That's mm-hmm. it.
You know, mm-hmm. it's not, as she was saying, it's not just about knocking each other, get up, you know.
Yes.
We have way gone, we surpass those standards. Mm-hmm. And I think those are the thing that keeps a marriage. Right, we need to explore each other, and we're gone from the days when we anything and they hide up with the towel.
We still have sisters that hide up with the towel, eh? Yes, and lift the long nightgown up.
Mm-hmm. We need to go past this, you know. We need to feel comfortable. Mm-hmm. You know, we need to explore each other. Mm-hmm. We need to, and I think what also adds to that is that, you know, we need to compliment each other.
Yes.
You understand, yes. honey? You know, saying, you know, compliment each other so that we could feel that sense of worth,
yes.
you know, and then we could start to, we have confidence now, so we could start to explore each other. I'll explore you. I'll rub your hand, I'll rub your foot, I'll pound your hand, you know,
yes.
explore each other and see what it is we like. And mm-hmm. from there, I think, you know, we could move on from there.
And more so knowing as women what satisfies us.
That's right.
Exactly.
And verbalize that too.
That's right.
So guys, we have less than 2 minutes. Paletta, I want you to just pray. Mm-hmm. We want to wind up with a prayer. Mm-hmm. And we're going to pray for women that been hurting, going through this.
Yes.
Don't know who to talk to about this. We're praying for healing for marriages and all mm-hmm. that. We have, you know, less than 2 minutes to do that. So guys, I am just going to say goodbye to you. And thank you so much for listening and tuning in to Heart of a Woman. Again, let us know how this program treats with you. If you like it, if you don't like it, if you find it too much out there, whatever, we can handle it. So from my heart to yours, bye-bye. Paletta.
Father, we just thank you and we praise you. And yes. we take this time of God to pray for our sisters who are there, who are hurting, who are in sexless and loveless marriages. God, we speak to healing. We speak to a heart of forgiveness. The heart of restoration, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord,
yes.
you have said what you have joined together, yes. Lord, let no man put asunder. So, Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus for rebuilding and rediscovering, oh God, of love mm-hmm. in our marriages, God.
Yes.
We pray, God, that you will bind us together with cords of love that cannot be broken, God. Speak to our hearts, to our minds, oh God, that we will seek, oh God, to please each other and to love each other the way that you have said in your word. So, Father, we thank you for what you are going to do, oh God,
yes.
that we're going to have marriages with a difference, and we just bless you, Lord, for doing it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This program comes to you compliments of Illinois International and Patricia's Bakery. Host makeup services provided by Beauty by Regine. Accessories for hosts provided by Afro Gypsy Nook. We'll be right back.
Patricia's Bakery, located Government House Road, Scarborough, Tobago. Striving to be the best in the industry in which we operate. Ensuring good customer service through quality performance. Daily we offer fresh, affordable and tasty products. Catering and delivery services available. We open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Contact us today at 365-0324 or 324-5606.